Ross and Missy Hyatt back with you on the main event. Very impressive debut by the Minnesota Wrecking Crew 2. They're looking right down the guns at the Steiners. But right now we're going to take a look at another tag team situation involving the United States Tag Team Championship. Missy, last week you said it was okay for Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express to borrow the belts, but it was just out-and-out thievery.
Why not? In my opinion, the guys that leave with the belts are the winners. And if Pillman and that Z-Man can't hold on to them and aren't man enough to keep them, then they shouldn't have them.
Well, fans, Flying Brian and Z-Man certainly do not have the belts now. They are still the United States Tag Team Champions. Jim Cornette's being fined $1,000 a day for every day that they keep these belts.
He can afford it, too.
Well, his mama can, that's for darn sure. But right now, we're going to go back to a piece of videotape from World Championship Wrestling. There's no doubt it was premeditated. The Midnight Express, led by Cornette, tried to break Flying Brian's neck. We're going to show you how that happened, and then we're going to hear from Jim Cornette.
Pillman, take a good look at what's over my shoulder. It's what you had, but you weren't man enough to keep. It's the Midnight Express's right and true property, the U.S. Tag Team Championship belts. Now, I realize the NWA is fining us $1,000 a day for every day that we have these belts, but that's a small price. That's a pittance. $1,000 a day to me, that's a phone call home to my mother. Because I want to make sure that the Midnight Express keeps their rightful property. We are the United States Tag Team Champions. And what you are, Pillman and Zinc, is a couple of punks. A couple of punks who couldn't keep your property. A couple of punks who got taught a lesson, and hopefully it's the last lesson they'll have to learn, because I got news for you, boys. If you try to come after the Midnight Express again, if you try to come after these belts and try to take them back, then what we're going to do to you is going to be a lot worse than what we did to that punk Pillman. So Z-Man especially, you got off just a little bit easy, so you think about that. You think about the pain that Pillman suffered from that beating. You think about the agony Pillman suffered from that beating, and you think if you want to suffer the same thing. I don't think you do. So, Zinc, Pillman, you just keep it in mind. You just bear it in mind that you were beaten by a better team, that you got a lesson early in your career in professional wrestling. And you also bear in mind that you'll never again have these belts, because the Midnight Express are going to be defending these all across the country, and we're going to keep them, too, against anybody that gets in our way. So, Zinc and Pillman, it was nice while it lasted, but it didn't last long, just like I said it wouldn't when you got in there with the Express.
Well, Cornette proving once again he's got a very big mouth, and I want to tell you, Flying Brian and Z-Man are looking forward to wrestling the Midnight Express and getting their belts back.
Oh, yeah, they want them back, but all I'm going to hear is whining and complaining from them. I just hope they're real men and they don't whine and complain. I mean, that always happens to me. Men always whining. Missy, I want this. Missy,
Fans, we will talk more about this situation. As a matter of fact, we will see the Midnight Express, the uncrowned United States Tag Team Champions, right after this timeout on TBS.
Under the tutelage of none other than James Cornette.
Outstanding combination. One of the greatest in all of professional wrestling as a tag team, the Midnight Express, with Jim Cornette in the corner. Beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan. They got
you
those.
Had them,
they
but you were
they stole those belts. He's
not.
Got the belts right there. They ran off with them. He stole them. They're not the rightful owners of the belts. The belts belonged to Z-Man and to Pillman.
What do you mean the belts belong to Z-Man and Pillman? Those guys wouldn't steal any belts. What do you think they got? Those guys are gangsters or something?
Pillman and Z-Man, the United States Tag Team Champions. And that's their belts that Jim Cornette has got over in the corner that he and the Midnight Express pilfered. We're talking about what a great team they are, and they are that. We saw earlier, too, what Cornette did. Look at that neck
breaker. What that neck breaker Bobby gave him there. Look at there.
I tell you, you can't take me.
And there's another one, Bob Cotto. He just gave him another neck breaker. Now, that's the way to work on a guy's neck.
And I tell you, the Midnight Express appears that they're determined to work on the opponent's necks. They did that with Pillman with the aid of that tennis racket from Cornette.
Well, I don't know where you've been getting your information from, Bob Cotto, but I've never seen anything like that before in my life, okay? I've never seen the Midnight Express do anything wrong.
There's beautiful Bobby with a hard right hand. Santo went flying back into the corner, held there now by Stan. They're quick, they're fast, they're like greased lightning in the ring.
That's why they're called the Midnight Express.
Look at Cornette, outside of the ring, he had that belt right into the eye and into the face.
All he's doing is just showing the guy the United States belt. He's not doing anything wrong.
He's showing it to him, and he's showing it to him up close. He can definitely read the fine print from there.
Well, maybe the guy's not got his, he doesn't have his contact lens on, so he's not able to see the belt. So Cornette just put it in his face.
Santo coming back with a good scoop and another one as he lifts. Beautiful Bobby Hyde of the air. Neck breaker again.
That Bobby is working right on that neck, Bob Cotto.
Boy, I tell you, Teddy, how many times can a man take a neck breaker like that and come back for more?
Well, I don't know. We must give this Santo a little credit, brother. He's really out there.
Here is Stan. Landed a couple of good hard right hands right to the midsection. An elbow as Santo came off of the rope. And Santo needs to get over to the corner for a tag. Don't you think that's where he should be right now?
Well, exactly. But the Midnight Express are smart, the smartest team. They're keeping him away from his corner.
Love it, boy. Come on, man. Come on, you piece of trash.
That's it, Bobby. Talk to him.
Oh, and there's Cornette with a racket. Always going to get a blow in if possible as Cornette is there outside of the ring. Here comes Johnson around trying to give his partner a little help, but he can't even get close to the action for the referee. Boy, they mauled him outside there, Teddy.
Well, that's the experience of the Midnight Express, and that just goes to show you they're the better team.
But Johnson is the fresh man outside of the ring in the other corner. And right now, Santo ought to be trying everything within his power to get to that side of the ring.
Well, Bob Cotto, if you've received as many blows as Santo's received, you might not even know which way to go to get to your corner.
Well, they work so well as a tag team. The beautiful Bobby and Sweet Stan. Stan, down goes Santo again. Now he's near the corner, but he didn't even reach up for a tag.
And they're staying within the rules, Bob Cotto. They're using an open fist.
Listen. Putting the belts up.
Yeah, Cornette out there. He was running his trap. I was trying to hear what he was talking about. Talking about those belts. Well, he's been holding them up to show everybody.
Like I said, the Midnight Express are the rightful owners of the United States Tag
Team
belt.
Here's a tag. Here's a tag. We're going to see Johnson now for the first time. He's got Bobby caught in his corner, but quickly, Bobby down the ropes, out of the corner, back towards Stan. Beautiful drop kick by Johnson. Arm drag takes him down again. Hey, he's showing some quickness.
Now, wait just a minute, Bob Cotto. See this, Johnson is balling up his hand there, using a fist. Now, that's illegal.
Boy, you talk about illegal. What do you call illegal when you got somebody like the Midnight and Cornette? Watch out. Out of the air with that suplex. Devastating move on the part of beautiful Bobby.
And Johnson's a little slow about getting up there, too.
Had him covered only for the count of two. He took his hands off. He didn't want to pin him, did he?
He's not ready yet. He's not ready yet. I don't blame Bobby Eaton there. He should put a little more punishment on Johnson. Poor soul, Brother Johnson.
Well, I tell you, he might be doing this to Johnson, and he might be doing it to Santo. But Pillman and Z-Man, that's a different story.
Well, let me tell you about Pillman and Z-Man. They're new kids on the block. They're trying to invade the neighborhood. So, brother, I tell you, they've got a task before them if they're going to reckon with the Midnight Express.
I tell you, if I was like Jim Cornette and I had something that belonged to Z-Man and belonged to Pillman, I would lay it down and walk away from it. I wouldn't want those two to be coming after it.
Well, that's you, Bob Cottle, okay? Jimmy Cornette has got guts.
Stand now with Johnson as he brings him hard down to the mat again, makes the tag. Watch out, here's Bobby, beautiful Bobby, the high flyer. He's going up to the top rope.
And when he goes up on that top and comes off, brother, you better believe that Johnson ain't gonna get up from that.
High in the air.
Oh, what a move there, Bobby Eaton.
Perfect landing, puts the hand down across the chest. One, two, three.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the Midnight.